Invasive species are a hot topic these days, and for good reason. They cause major problems in Virginia, outcompeting our native beneficial species, and can negatively impact our waterways, our forests, and our agriculture, and even health throughout the state. Invasive species are also expensive. It's really important to stop the spread, but it comes with a price tag in Virginia of about $1 billion a year. But what exactly is an invasive species, and what can we do to help? Let's find out. To understand what an invasive species is, first we need to understand what a native and a non-native species is. A native species is one that naturally occurs in an area. This means that it's well-suited to the climate, the growing conditions, the weather, and it's an important part of the ecosystem. On the other hand, a non-native species is one that does not occur naturally in that area and was brought there by humans, sometimes on purpose and other times by accident. There are plenty of non-native plants that don't have any sizable negative impact on our ecosystem. This includes horticulture plants like daffodils or many of our food crops such as carrots or tomatoes. However, some of those non-native plants do begin to cause problems and can have a negative impact on human health, the ecosystem, or our economy. At that point, once they start causing problems, they're considered an invasive species. In Virginia, some of our most problematic invasive species are feral pigs, tree of heaven, or the emerald ash borer. What about native species that some people might consider problematic, like poison ivy? Well, it's important to remember that in order for a species to be invasive, it has to be both non-native and problematic. And since poison ivy is a native species, it cannot be invasive. Some of these species that are a little bit aggressive, we tend to call aggressive natives. They might spread in an area rapidly or cause pest problems, but they aren't as problematic on a wide scale as our invasive species are. Native, non-native, and invasive species can be a plant, an animal, a fungal pathogen, or another organism. But here at the Virginia Department of Forestry, we're excited to be focusing new efforts on invasive plant management throughout the state. We're working on new educational resources and videos all about invasive plant management, and we'll teach you how you can manage invasives in your backyard at home. We'll talk all about invasive plant identification and how you can differentiate them from other plants that might be native or at least not invasive. We'll also learn all about control methods, including manual control and chemical control, and we'll even talk about herbicides and how you can safely use herbicides at home. For our most up-to-date resources, head to www.dof.virginia.gov and search for invasive plants.